This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Hi there, you're watching the late night news on NDTV Hindu. So yes, the Chennai Super Kings have done it. We are the champions of the Indian Premier League. I'm Ramnathan with all the news and updates.
I'm Natasha Daraiswamy, and the Chennai Super Kings have been crowned kings of IPL 3. Yeah!
All right, all those three cheers and all the info from Natasha in a short while. But before that, the top stories tonight. Chennai Super Kings make the city proud, win the IPL 3 beating Mumbai Indians by a good 22 runs. Violent clashes at the Madras High Court in the presence of the Chief Minister and the Chief Justice of India. Media attack at the High Court, NDTV Hindu crew attacked along with three other camera persons by the unruly mob. Nalini's lawyer tells NDTV Hindu that drug trafficking is rampant at the Vellore jail. One more reason to shift Nalini to Puyal prison. Well, the huge victory, and at a long last, Chennai Super Kings finally winning the IPL crown. We get you all the action on our special segment, Cricket Carnival. Well, finally, the Chennai Super Kings did it. The Kings have been crowned the champions of IPL Season 3. They beat the mighty Mumbai Indians in Mumbai by a margin of 22 runs. Choosing to bat first, the Yellow Brigade scored 158 for 5, riding high on a brilliant half-century by Suresh Rana. The battle went down to the wires as Mumbai Indians scored 146 for 9.
Their campaign was good. Was almost gone. They needed to win 6 of their last. It doesn't matter what happens on this ball.
Well, joining us live now is our sports reporter Natasha. Natasha, been a long night for all of us, but tell me, all the fans there and you still have the energy to party through the night. The occasion calls for it, doesn't it?
Absolutely, Ram. It's been a fun ride all the way from the beginning of the tournament till now. And it's been worthwhile actually waiting for Super Kings to actually come to this stage. We've been through IPL 1. We fought our way through. We didn't manage to get through. Finally, as well as IPL 2. And now we've come to IPL 3. We've been crowned Super Kings, definitely, of IPL 3. We've deserved this long wait. We fought our way through. Not many people believed in us. We have definitely believed in us. How do you feel? Let's get patriotic and sing the anthem, shall we?
Yes!
Celebration, I must say, really. Yeah. And I'm sure we're all going to go on through the night and tomorrow and day after. Yeah. But first thing, I want to come to you. Are you celebrating that Kieran Pollard was brought down the order and he didn't really perform? Sort of, it was a little too late. Do you believe the same?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the person?
Yeah. In fact, it was good for Chennai that he came down. If he would have turned up, then definitely would have been really tough.
Really tough to challenge.
Okay. Well, we definitely fear that Sachin Tendulkar, obviously, at the end, he was definitely in. It wasn't so much that he had damaged the web of his hand. How do you think he performed? He definitely did pretty well in the beginning, and after that, a great catch at the boundary.
Yeah.
What do you say?
It's a good catch. It was a good catch, but basically, it was not Sachin exactly what he was earlier, because we were aware of the fact that he was injured, but somehow we basically...
Sachin.
Against Sachin. Simple. We cannot say much against Sachin. But Sachin is Sachin.
Okay. What about Suresh Raina? Now, do you think he's the savior?
He's the match winner.
He's the match winner for Chennai today.
Okay. So the finals now has been the deciding factor for a very long time. How do you think you're going to celebrate? How do you think the Chennai Super Kings boys are going to celebrate?
It's just
Arva is going to celebrate very well because hamara paisa vasool.
Well, this is the mood right here in Chennai. It's celebration. Time after time, it's going to go on for a very long time now. And Chennai Super Kings truly deserves this win. Even Hayden, even though he dropped that very important catch, he performed then again. And just like all our other players, back to you, Ram, in the studio.
Right, thanks a lot, Natasha, for joining us with all those crazy fans out there. And please, yeah, party the night out. I think the occasion calls for that. Well, moving on, not so good news. Another top story of the evening. Violence at the High Court again, and the media attacked right in front of the cameras and the Chief Minister, who is responsible for the shameful incident. A function organized by the Tamil Nadu government at the Madras High Court turned ugly. Lawyers showed black flags to the Chief Minister, even threw chairs, and all this happened with the Chief Justice of India and the Union Law Minister just 50 meters away. Sam Daniel reports.
A government function on the premises of the Madras High Court gone wrong. Lawyers asking the Chief Minister to stop his speech. They shouted slogans, even threw chairs. All this with the Chief Justice of India and the Union Law Minister within striking distance.
And what do you have to say about what happened today, sir?
You wait here now, wait here.
Some lawyers were upset that Karunanidhi did not act against senior police officers responsible for last year's violent clashes between advocates and cops on the High Court campus, despite the High Court recommending disciplinary action.
The government did not take any action. That is what minor group of lawyers, they don't want the Chief Minister to be present in this occasion. And having invited him, insulting him, it's an insult to the society.
Even a year after the lawyer-police clash on the Madras High Court campus, all is not well between the advocates and the Tamil Nadu government. And journalists continue to be the target of attack. Hello. Cameras were smashed and journalists attacked. Our camera person Devraj suffered injuries.
So it is indeed disturbing that such a violence had to be enacted at a venue where the Chief Minister and the Law Minister were present, and the police remained mute spectators.
Six lawyers have been arrested, but the Chief Minister tried to downplay the incident. A big embarrassment for the Tamil Nadu government. Ugly scenes taking away from the function meant to honour the architect of our constitution. With Bertila and camera person Sukumar and Devraj, in Chennai, Sam Daniel for NDTV.
Meanwhile, the blame game has started. One of the advocates who was arrested following the violence says it was the members of the DMK who were behind the unrest.
எங்கள் மீது குண்டர்களை வைத்து அதாவது 19-2 போலீசாரை வைத்து தாக்கிய இதே முதல்வர் இப்பொழுது ரவுடிகளை திமுக ரவுடிகளை வைத்து தாக்கி கொடூரமாக தாக்கியிருக்கிறார் அந்த வகையில் இந்த ஆட்சி ஜனநாயகபூர்வமான ஆட்சி அல்ல இது ஒரு போலீஸ் காட்டாட்சி ரவுடிகளுடைய காட்டாட்சி
Well, here are those dramatic visuals of our camera person being attacked by the unruly mob at the High Court this morning. As you can see on your screens, our cameraman being brutally attacked by a group of men dressed in white and black, being brutally punched, kicked and abused. We can also hear the Chief Minister speaking in the background, addressing the gathering. So all of this happened right in front of the Chief Minister. While the Chief Minister spoke, these men pounced on a video journalist. Truly a shameful incident at the High Court, a place which is meant to deliver justice. Our reporter Bertila and camera person Devraj joined us to narrate their harrowing experience at the High Court campus this morning.
This morning we were covering the unveiling of the Dr. Ambedkar statue at the Madras High Court. And at that time, two men in colored clothes came to me and they said, they actually threatened us, telling you need to leave the place immediately. We are telling you for your own safety, you just need to go right here with your camera person, take him and leave this place. And you can ask camera person Devraj what happened to him at the mob action there. Devraj, can you tell them?
நான் கிட்ட போயிட்டு அதாவது ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணும்போது பின்னாடி இருந்து சத்தம் கேட்டுருந்துச்சு. சரி, லாங்லேருந்து எடுக்கும் என்னால் நான் வந்து கொஞ்சம் ஹைட் கம்மியாக இருந்தேன், என்னால் கிட்ட போய் எடுக்க என்னால் எடுக்கிற அளவுக்கு அங்கே எதுவும் தெரியல எனக்கு. இருந்தது ஒரு சேர் மட்டும் மேலே மேலே வந்துட்டு இருந்துச்சு. சரி, கொஞ்சம் கிட்ட போனோடனே ஒரு ரெண்டு மூணு பேர் சேர்ந்து தள்ளிட்டு வந்தாங்க. அந்த கும்பலோட கும்பல் தள்ளிட்டு வந்தாங்க. தள்ளினோடனே நானும் கொஞ்சம் வெளியில் போயிட்டேன். வெளியில் போன அடுத்த செகண்டில் வந்து என்னை பிடிச்சி கேமரா கையிலேருந்து பிடுங்குறது, இது வந்து பிடிச்சி அடித்து ஃபுல்லாக அடித்து என்ன பண்ணாங்க, எப்படி அடிக்கணும் எப்படி அசிங்கமா பேசணும் அந்த மாதிரி பண்ணாங்க. பிடிச்சி கழுத்தெல்லாம் நெருக்கி காலை பிடிச்சி மெரிச்சு ஒருத்தர் வந்து கையை போட்டு அமுக்குறாங்க, ஒருத்தர் கேமரா பிடுங்குறாங்க. ஒவ்வொருத்தரும் ஒரு மாதிரி ஒரு 20 பேர் 10 சேர்ந்த மாதிரி கும்பல் வந்து மொத்தமா பிடுங்குறாங்க. என்னால கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணவே முடியல, எதுவும் செய்ய முடியல. அந்த கண்டிஷன்ல வந்து என்னால முடிஞ்ச வரைக்கும் கேமரா காப்பு முடிவு எடுக்கணும் அப்படின்னு நினைச்சா என்னால என்னோட சேஃப்டி வந்து கேமரா தான். கேமரா ஃபுல்லா வந்து நான் என்னோட இது கண்ட்ரோல் கொண்டு வர பார்த்தா என்னால முடியல. அப்புறம் எனக்கு கீழே மறிச்சு கழுத்துல ஒருத்தர் காலை வச்சுட்டு கேமரா கையில இருந்து பிடுங்கி எடுத்துட்டு போனாங்க. ஃபுல்லா அடிச்சு அதுக்கப்புறம் ஒருத்தர் வந்து அடிச்சு கேட் வரைக்கும் எடுத்துட்டு போய் வெளியில எடுத்து விட்டுட்டு வந்தாங்க. வெளியில நீ தூரம் கேட் உள்ள வரக்கூடாது, கேட் உள்ள வந்தா வெளில அதான் சொல்லிட்டு உன் வீரடுக்கும் இருக்கிறது கஷ்டம் தான், வெளில போயிட்டு அப்படின்ற மாதிரி சுத்தினாங்க. சரி, என்னுடைய உயிரை காப்பாத்திக்கிறதுக்காக நான் வந்து என்னோட கேமரா கொடுத்துட்டு நான் வெளியில வந்துட்டேன்.
Our reporter Shabir has been following that story through the day and he gave us the latest on the story.
Well, that is the situation, and the situation continues and it remains to be the same, because we have been trying to contact the police officials. They very clearly say that it is just a minor incident and nothing important in it, and they have also not told us that who were the attackers. So that's the big question which has to be answered. Who are the attackers? Who attacked media and who attacked the advocate? So why was such an unruly mob allowed inside the High Court premises when they know that the situation is not all is not well at the Madras High Court? Because this Black Flag protest was actually announced a week ago, and after that there were several campaigns on this particular issue. And then how come these unruly mob were allowed inside, and where did they come from and who brought them? And we do know that the advocates have accused and alleged that they belong to the ruling DMK party. So if they belong to the ruling DMK party, who has brought them inside? So these are the questions which are yet to be answered, and we have been seeking answers from the police department, but so far there is no reaction from the police, and they say that it is just a minor incident and nothing much to be added on this particular issue. But we do know that there are also reports that some of the DMK leaders have brought these men inside the High Court premises. So who are those leaders and who are those ringleaders who actually masterminded this entire event? So that is something which is yet to be probed. And right now the police have not reacted officially on this particular issue.
Now, the Madras Union of Journalists have also condemned these attacks on media persons in a statement issued earlier. D. Suresh Kumar, the General Secretary of the Union, said, and I quote, "It is a shocking that journalists who were discharging their professional duties were physically attacked for filming scenes of violence during a clash between two group of advocates. Even more shocking is the fact that policemen who were present at this scene did nothing to prevent the attack," unquote. The statement also said that the Madras Union of Journalists demands the immediate arrest of those involved in the attacks on media persons. The government should also compensate the injured journalists and the expensive television camera equipment which were damaged in the process. Up on the other side, the other big story of the day: what is the new twist in the Nalini saga? Stay with us to find out more.